season. We just saw one example right there. Now the former Washington Husky, here's Myles Gaskin. And tough going there as he'll only get it up to about the 31. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine. On the handoff, it's Gaskin. Only gets 3 yards there on the heels of the 1 yard pickup. Sets up third and six. This defense for the Chiefs, they were terrific last week in the win over Denver.
And the big difference in the ball game, their ability to force turnovers, three of them in fact. Being able to take the ball away, give it back to their offense, that's something that's emphasized each and every week, and they carried it out.
Throwing is Tagovailoa on third down here. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Nick Bolton. And they'll strike with great field position at the 41-yard line. Not a good omen there. His first throw of the afternoon, intercepted.
And I know what the fans are thinking right now. I hope there's not negative thoughts in his head going forward since that's his first throw of the game. But one of the things I remember about him coming out of school is he's able to wipe things away pretty easily and move on.
First and 10, it's Edwards-Helaire with it. And he's got Rome, the 20, 10, 5, and all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown. Clyde Edwards-Helaire. Hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Chiefs are going to take a first quarter lead. Extra point by Butker is on target. And it's now a 7-0 game. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. Coming off every player's friend, the open week from last weekend.
Oh, there's no doubt about that. Even if you're coming off of a loss as they did, the open week is exactly...
And this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. It's a big play there for Miami. Excellent execution, and now they're set up nicely.
Are they ever? Red zone? I wonder what the next play call is going to be, because after a big play like that, a lot of teams like to use the momentum to launch another one.
Here's Gaskin, and he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play there, second down.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature at the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. He's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. They'll run now with Gaskin, and he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
third down, an extra DB out there for the Chiefs. Looking to pass. Tua. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense these past few downs. Able to knock that one away on third down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected fourth down here.
The kick by Sanders is good. So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well, and kudos to you. You didn't jinx him.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And they, as mentioned, unbeaten to this point in the year. But you think this game, their toughest test yet.
I absolutely do, because to me, this is a good measuring stick game because they've been able to take advantage of the schedule. But here, this is another team leading its division with an eye on making a Super Bowl run. So this game is crucial.
The first down run got five. Here's second and five. Now the Dolphins are going to halt the action here. It's a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and five. Throwing now is Mahomes. And he's got his man on the out route. And he gets this up to the 34 out of bounds there.
If you're running out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
Edwards-Helaire, they'll try to run for it. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down.
Not the kind of gain that we'll go absolutely crazy for, but it's the kind of gain that you need to have when you're running back in the NFL, and Clyde Edwards-Helaire, with that low center of gravity and strength, he's going to get those tough, gritty yards for you when necessary.
And in their own territory, needing only a few inches, they're going to line up to go for this thing on fourth down. And he'll be touched out here, but not before he does pick up the first.
But when you do call quarterback sneak, you don't mind if your quarterback's a little bit on the vertically challenged side, do you? Because he's just going to hide behind his big guys up front and be able to surge forward and pick up the first down.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now this time Mahomes will throw. They'll roll him out right. Oh, now he'll try and chuck it deep left side. And it is incomplete. Good positioning there downfield to break that one up. But partner, this offense 12-0 now on the year following their latest victory. And during the week, a lot of folks making comparisons between this squad and the 1985 Bears. You know, they too were 12-0 at this juncture of the season before losing on a Monday night 38-24 to the Dolphins at the Orange Bowl way back on December 2nd of 85. But then they'd never lose again en route to winning Super Bowl 20.
And when you look back on it, partner, didn't it almost feel like a setup game? Because they were playing the Dolphins, and the Dolphins were protecting their franchise's undefeated season of 1972, that team. And you know what that team does. They love to celebrate the fact that they still are the only one to get through an entire NFL season that way. That was Dan Marino's third year playing under the great Don Shula, and they were motivated to keep that franchise's record intact.
And now here's a deep shot that's complete. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. It's a big play there for the Chiefs.
When they've needed a play this year, he's certainly been the guy to deliver. And as this season has gone on, he's been awfully consistent and sometimes spectacular.
After one, 7-3 the score on EA Sports. They go back to the ground with Edwards-Helaire. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. 59 yards rushing for him now, and he's carried the ball just five times.
I'm not sure how much more evidence they need, partner, than to understand that if they don't start to slow him down, it's going to be a long afternoon here at the stadium because he is just shredding them at this point. And let's face it, coming into the game, they knew he would be the focal point of their attack. This is going to take an 11-man unit on the defensive side to start making plays.
They fake the give. Now Mahomes. He'll buy some time right. And he'll get this into the hands of Hill. Complete. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7.
That's a big league job there of getting out of the pocket, not panicking, and just buying himself some time. Then he made a good, accurate throw to set up first and goal.
They'll run with Edwards-Helaire. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal. Be interesting to see now what they do offensively down near the goal line after not much there that time.
As the offensive play caller, that may change your sequence now. Instead of coming right back with a running play, you may have to go to the air.
The 6-yard line, the line of scrimmage on second and goal. One more time with Edwards-Helaire. And he will take it on in for a Chiefs touchdown. Clyde Edwards-Helaire with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Chiefs are able to grow their lead. Extra point by Butker is on target. And that pushes the lead up to 11. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And there, of course, was a lot of talk about this ball game coming into play. Two division leaders in the AFC. Blitz coming and down he goes. So they will accept the penalty and move forward. Tagovailoa and the Dolphins come up first and 10, right at the 30. A play fake for Gaskin. Now Tua. He's going to air one out. Got a man. It's caught inside the 10. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown. Quite a show of arm strength right there. That was in the air for a long time, and it was on target, too.
And I'm telling you, nothing will light up a crowd more than a play like that. Here in the stadium, all eyes were on the receiver streaking downfield, and you know everyone was thinking, throw it, he's open. What a connection there for the touchdown.
Extra point up and good by Sanders. And the lead is down to four. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. This fielded right at the goal line. And he brings us out past the 20 to the 24. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
And I think they'd be well served to take that type of a physical approach against him the rest of the game. He's had his way so far, but on that last one, that worked quite well for the defense.
Second and 10. To throw, it's Mahomes. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45.
That last throw moves him past 27,989 yards for his career, so that means he moves ahead of the blonde bomber, Terry Bradshaw, on the all-time list.
And boy, he loved to throw it downfield, didn't he? That's why he was the blonde bomber. Remember, he threw it downfield to John Stallworth and Lynn Swan? It was gorgeous. Big throws, big plays. Terry Bradshaw.
They'll run. It's Edwards-Helaire. And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. The Chiefs now going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Second and 11. They go play fake. Mahomes eluding the pressure right. All in all, no gain on the play, and it'll bring up third.
Well, he strung it out as far as he could, and I like the fact that he kept his eyes downfield, but he finally ran out of time and room. But I'll take that over forcing it downfield and possibly having it intercepted.
Throwing is Mahomes on third. Going right side here, and that's complete. And he will have a Chiefs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
So now first and 10 as they've crossed into Miami territory at the 42-yard line. Now Mahomes. This pass going to be caught by Hardman. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Here's second and 10.
Mahomes now to throw. And going deep for Hill. And this one incomplete. Oh, he couldn't hang on to it in the end zone. And that's one that'll haunt you. And now it brings up third down. This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. On play action, it's Mahomes. And going deep for Hill. This is caught by Hill for a Chiefs touchdown. Tyreek Hill, his 19th touchdown now of the season. And the Chiefs add on to their lead. Extra point by Butker is on target, and that makes it a 21-10 game. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return. Down Miami as they get set to start the drive. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, to see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last time.
That's
true. That's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense, not giving up the long pass. They did. Let's see how they adjust.
A reminder, coming up at halftime, we'll send you up to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman is there, and he'll have stats and scores from a busy Sunday in the NFL. Give him 3 yards, and now they're left needing a conversion here on third and six. Now a second timeout called for by the defense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Now Tua. That's complete to his tight end, Mike Gesicki. The Chiefs quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. So from the 36 now, first and 10. This is Gaskin on the carry. And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
I have a feeling they'll stay committed to running the football, especially on the early downs. They just haven't had a whole lot of success just yet.
So after the loss of a yard, they'll look to push forward here on second down and 11. Play action, now it's Tua. He's going to loft it, deep right sideline. And this is caught, and finally out of bounds all the way down at about the 2. Now they face a second and long following the holding penalty. Off of play action, Tagovailoa. He's letting this one go for Fuller. He's got a man complete. Now the Dolphins will use the last of their timeouts as they'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the first down. A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone.
Right there, 54, right there.
A handoff as they run the counter play. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. A good response by the defense, sending them backwards after that huge gain last play. That loss of three, a rare stumble on a promising drive. Here's second and 13. Here's Tua. And he's not able to get away. Sacked back at the 22. Chris Jones able to record his fifth sack of the season. So now after the sack, Tua and the Dolphins staring at a third and long. Throwing now is Tagovailoa. Oh, he rifles one, that's going to be intercepted. Picked off down near the five. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half.
Well, Brandon, there's no question who they're going to look to on third and long, but you can bet this defense knows that as well, so they've got him blanketed downfield. And this ball winds up being intercepted.
Final shot before the half from Mahomes. Escaping the pressure right. So we've reached halftime with the visiting Chiefs on top. As we go up to Orlando now and hand it over to Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach.
Both teams likely making their final adjustments before the second half. So, time for us to go back downstate to Miami and rejoin Brandon and Charles.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Dolphins down on the scoreboard, but they'll have it first as we get going in this third quarter. And that one bounces out of the back of the end zone, so we'll start the drive at the 25 on the touchback. Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And they trail here to begin the second half. What's going to be a key for them to get back in the game?
I think they're right there, and I think this game is still up for the taking for them because we always talk about turnovers. They had two of them in the first half, and once you start talking about if you have three, four, or five, you know it's beyond difficult to try and win a football game with that. Those have to be eliminated. If they take care of the ball, they've still got a shot.
So the incompletion, and now it's second and 10, again from the 25-yard line. Now a handoff as they run left side, and he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down, then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
Out of the gun on third down, here's Tua. Got a man open, that's Devontae Parker complete. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
And as a quarterback, you always want to exploit gaps in the defense. And he finds one here. Crossing route, working from right to left across the field. And once you get defenders going in the wrong direction, it is awfully hard for them to pivot back, and you end up getting the first down.
Mike's 50. Exit.
They run the counter now on first down. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. Tua going to throw. Flush to his right. That's going to be caught by Waddle. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll work this forward for about three at second down. Now they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe it'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
On second and seven, Tua looking left side and has got a man. That's Parker. He's still on his feet. Touchdown! Devontae Parker, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Dolphins able to get this back within a touchdown.
I know these wide receivers are about flash and dash and high-flying plays, but a good number of them played running back at some point in their career, and that's how they finish off a lot of their big plays, run after the catch.
And this time he finishes off the big play in the end zone. So now the Dolphin offense will stay out there as they'll go for two. The two are going to try and throw for it. Oh, and Tua going to be intercepted for the third time. Picked up by Juan Thornhill. And the Dolphins are going to have the football here at their own 35-yard line. Will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And maybe some renewed pressure on this unit following the touchdown a moment ago. It's back to a one-score game.
And because of that pressure, because it's now a one-score game, they know this is where you need to slow the momentum change. Because otherwise, that could overrun your team. You've got to be careful right here.
78 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon. First down, Chiefs. Inside 4 minutes to go, third quarter. Play action. Now it's Mahomes. Catch is made by Hardman. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down.
I'll tell you what, a lot of those mid-range throws have been available because sometimes teams get too concerned about the deep ball and they leave too much space in front of them. And these guys have been taking advantage so far.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Looking to throw is Mahomes. Locates Hardman for another catch. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Only needing 2 yards on second down. Here's Edwards-Helaire. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30.
Second and two is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks moving.
So first and 10 now from the 30. They'll run here with Edwards-Helaire. And a nice move will yield nothing as he's stopped behind the line. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down. Edwards-Helaire down to the 30 after a gain of 3. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
An important play right here, 3rd and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
Here's Mahomes to throw. Going up top. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
That's a good job there creating the contact to force the incompletion. And now since it's 4th down, that should set up a field goal situation.
And a nice sigh of relief defensively to be able to hold them to 3. Butker's kick here is good. And that'll push the lead up to 8. So a nice kick there as they are able to add on to their lead.
And that's exactly what you're looking to do. Maneuver yourself into range. That way, if your drive stalls out, you're able to get something out of it. And they do so right there.
And that'll be a little too hot to handle as it will skip through the end zone for a touchback here. First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great end. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. They'll wind up losing 8 on the sack there, and it's 2nd down. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest one is maybe you bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. 0 accountability, and a sack resulted.
Just a 1 yard loss that time, but that's not what they needed. Now they're dealing with a 3rd and long. From the gun, it's Tua. This will be caught. It's Waddle. And he will be taken down, but a big pickup there on what's going to be the final play of the 3rd quarter. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4. 2nd and 6.
end of all that hitting and hollering. It was a four-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
Second and six. Now a play fake. Here's Tagovailoa. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. It'll be a loss of only a couple on the sack, but now it'll bring up third down. They tried to go with a little play action there, but nobody on the defensive side bit.
Yeah, they adjusted in time and in a big way and ultimately got the sack. On offense, sometimes you're running play action just to set up a certain blocking technique. In this case, none of it worked.
Throwing is Tagovailoa on third down here. Open receiver here, complete, it's Parker. And he'll be brought down with a first down as the tackle's made at the Chiefs' 34-yard line.
And that's a much-needed first down right there. Look, they're down by eight, so logic says they don't have to get a touchdown out of this drive. But the way things are going, I don't know if I'd put it in the hands of my defense here. You might not get the ball back at all. So if a fourth down situation comes up, I'm thinking hard about going for it right here and right now.
Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive here. Second and 11. Going to the air. Tagovailoa. This throw incomplete, nearly picked off. And with his pedigree, he doesn't drop many of those. But third down coming up. A long way to go here on third down for the eighth play of the drive. Tua sets up to pass it. Oh, and Tua going to be intercepted for the third time. Picked off at the 25. And they have the football and will take over at the 24-yard line. Well, that's three picks he's now thrown in this game.
And I know this, the holiday season, because here we are in December.
Season of giving.
Right, it is the season of giving. Maybe for his own sake after the game, he may have to announce that he's donating certain amounts to charity for each interception that he threw.
Oh, he faked it with a juke. Now he's got some room. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 101 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long. First down. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. To throw, it's Mahomes. Completes it to Hardman. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. Charles, you'd said the magic number was probably right around 20 for this defense because they're facing one of the top five offenses in the league in terms of points scored. They've had their moments, but this offense, just a little too good, isn't it?
They really are, because no matter what you do to make an adjustment on defense, they've had an answer for it.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And the lane closes up quickly as he'll get about three down to the 38. I'm sure that that's going to be the formula. Just keep the ball on the ground. Keep that clock moving.
And when you have the lead this late in the game, above all, stay in bounds. Yes, take care of the football. Yes, gain yardage, but stay in bounds and let that clock tick.
Clock continuing to run. They'll probably wind this all the way before snapping it on second down.
Hey, 43, 43, 15.
A shotgun snap and a give to Edwards-Helaire. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. Now they're going to be dealing with a third and seven. Is that one officially a loss of one?
Hey,
From the gun, it's Mahomes. And he's going to get this inside the 30.
And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
So frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
And he'll work this forward for about three. It's second down. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So the Chiefs in possession of the ball as we welcome you back. They've got a second down now as they search for a way to get this one to the finish line. They'll try a little trickery here on the end around. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. Now they're staring at a 3rd and 8. That last play backwards a yard. To throw. Flushed out right. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. And that throw there going to put him over 4,000 yards passing now for the season, maybe strengthening his MVP consideration.
And you figure with still a handful of games left to play, 5,000 yards is not totally out of the realm of possibility. The way he is playing, I think he's going to get there.
It's first and goal and a late touchdown at this stage. Could officially salt this one away. Clock counting down toward 40 seconds as they take the knee. So they're backed up to the 3-yard line, 2nd and goal. Defense still with 3 timeouts. We'll see if they want to use them here as the kneel down comes. Tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, 3rd and goal, and they take a knee. So this one in the win column for Kansas City, and they were spurred on by a strong performance in that 4th quarter as they held their opponents off the scoreboard.
Everyone wants to pitch a shutout for the entire game, but when you throw
nobody help when I was hungry. Fake friends, they just slipping away.